Hello, today we are going to discuss about the thermodynamics. As you can see, thermal basically is two parts. Thermal, that basically represents the heat, and then we have dynamics, that basically represents the force. Now, it is a very important branch of science, so which basically deals with the transfer or transformation of energy. So anywhere jahan bhi aapke paas energy transfer ho rahi hai or transform ho rahi hai from one form to another form, usko describe karne ke liye we basically need thermodynamics science. Clear? Now we have various physical processes which are occurring in the nature, and because of those processes we have to describe them. So to describe various physical processes which are occurring in nature and to describe the various physical properties of the different substances, we need thermodynamics. So it is basically a branch of science which deals with the transfer or transformation of energy during any physical process that is taking place, and what is the relation among the different physical properties of that particular process which are changing due to the process that is taking place. Now in our daily life we basically deals with lot of thermodynamics problems. For example, as you can see, all the things jo hamare surrounding mein ho rahi hai, they are all natural, but they are not random, they have some directional constraints. For example, you can see jab bhi aapki heat transfer hoti hai, वो ट्रांसफर होती है हमेशा फ्रॉम हायर टेम्परेचर टूवर्ड्स लोअर टेम्परेचर. उसका जो रिवर्स है वो कभी भी नहीं होगा. सेकेंडली, यू गाइस कैन सी दैट जब भी हम मैकेनिकल एनर्जी को कन्वर्ट करते हैं हीट एनर्जी में, इट इज डायरेक्टली पॉसिबल टू कन्वर्ट द मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इनटू हीट एनर्जी 100%, बट वी कैन नॉट कन्वर्ट द हीट एनर्जी इनटू मैकेनिकल एनर्जी और वर्क 100% एफिशिएंटली. सो देयर आर सम कंस्ट्रेंट दैट इन सम कंडीशंस वी कैन कन्वर्ट द मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इनटू हीट एनर्जी एंटायरली. फॉर एग्जांपल, जब आप ब्रेक अप्लाई करते हो, आपकी गाड़ी मूव कर रही है, वी आर कन्वर्टिंग काइनेटिक एनर्जी इनटू हीट एनर्जी. बट अगर आपने उसका रिवर्स करना हो फ्रॉम हीट एनर्जी टू काइनेटिक एनर्जी और मैकेनिकल एनर्जी, वो 100% प्रैक्टिकली पॉसिबल नहीं है इवन अंडर आइडियल कंडीशंस. सो वी हैव सम डायरेक्शनल कंस्ट्रेंट्स. प्रोसेसेस आर अकरिंग इन नेचर, क्लियर, बट दे आर नॉट रैंडम, दे हैव सम कंस्ट्रेंट्स. ऑल द प्रोसेसेस आर अकरिंग अंडर दैट सम कंस्ट्रेंट कंडीशंस. सो study of all these processes basically comes under thermodynamics. Clear? Now we have to study them. Clear? So we have to take a separate space on which we are focused, on which we have to find the what are the changes occurring in that particular space or that particular region. So that is basically called a system. So you all know about what is system, what is surrounding, what is boundary. Clear? So basically we are going to tell you what is system. System basically is a part which is under observation, or basically we can say जिस portion को आप, जिस space of region को आप study कर रहे हो, that what are the chemical processes, what are the physical changes that are basically occurring in that space, that particular region, that basically called a system. So it is the area under consideration or area under concentration जिसके ऊपर आप focus कर रहे हो. Now system basically is of different types. As you all know that we have open system, we have open system, then we have closed system, and third one is known as isolated system. We all of I think are aware of it. It is called isolated system. So basically we are having three types of systems: open system, closed system and isolated system. As I told you, system basically kya hai, area under consideration jisko aap study kar rahe ho. Let us suppose this is my area which is under consideration. So basically jitni bhi aapke paas physical processes occur kar rahe hain wo is region ke andar kar rahe hain, and I have to study it. So open system basically is a system in which mass as well as energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. This is my system. It means mass from the outside can flow into system, and the mass from the system will move outside also. So mass can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. Now what is surrounding? Clear? This is my system that is under consideration. All the part basically that basically enclose the system, जो इसके आपका बाहर वाला रीजन जितना भी रहेगा सिस्टम के, that basically represents the surrounding. So this entire area basically represents the surrounding. Okay, so this is the open system in which mass as well as energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. So I'm writing energy in, energy out, although there are different forms of transferring energy. We have work, we have heat, it can be heat in or heat out also. So the system in which mass as well as energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. This is my system, which is exchanging mass as well as energy with the surrounding. So this basically is an example of open system. Clear? Secondly, we have closed system. Now, let us suppose we have one more system. This is the space origin under consideration. Clear? So the system in which only energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. So energy can be only exchanged. Energy will be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. But there is no exchange of mass. It means mass cannot be exchanged. इसके अंदर आपका जो matter content रहेगा वो जितना है fix रहेगा, वो आपका change नहीं होगा. इसकी आपके पास जो best example है क्लोज सिस्टम की, let us suppose this is a system. For example, अगर आपने किसी पिस्टन सिलेंडर एग्जमेंटिंग में कि आपने गैस को इंट्रैप करके रखा हुआ है, जो उसके वाल्व है उसको क्लोज कराया हुआ आपने, तो अगर उसको आप प्रेस कर रहे हो या कंप्रेस कर रहे हो, तो उसका जो प्रेशर या वॉल्यूम है वो इंक्रीज करेगा या फिर डिक्रीज करेगा, बट उसके अंदर का जो मास है वो क्या रहेगा, फिक्स रहेगा, वो चेंज नहीं होगा. सो पिस्टन सिलेंडर अरेंजमेंट में अगर आप किसी गैस को कंटेन करके उसको क्लोज करा रहे हो, उसको वाल्व को, उस कंडीशन में भी यू विल से दैट इट इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ क्लोज सिस्टम. सो इन द क्लोज सिस्टम, जब आप उसको क्लोज करोगे, मैटर आपका एक्सचेंज नहीं होगा बिटवीन द सिस्टम एंड द सराउंडिंग, बट द एनर्जी कैन बी एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द सिस्टम एंड द सराउंडिंग. तो उसको अगर आप हीट दोगे बाहर से, तो आपकी गैस जो एक्सपेंड कर जाएगी, अगर आप वहां से हीट रिमूव करोगे तो वो कंडक्ट करेगा, बट द मैटर जो उसके अंदर है दैट विल रिमेन फिक्स. क्लियर? सो लास्ट वन दैट इज कॉल्ड आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम. लेट अस सपोज वी आर अगेन हैविंग अ सिस्टम. सो अ सिस्टम इन विच नीदर मास नोर एनर्जी कैन बी एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द सिस्टम एंड द सराउंडिंग. तो जिस सिस्टम में आपके पास ना तो मास ना ही एनर्जी को आप एक्सचेंज कर सकते हो बिटवीन द सिस्टम एज वेल एज बिटवीन द सराउंडिंग, दैट बेसिकली इज कॉल्ड आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम. सो आपके पास इसकी जो बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल है वो क्या है, थर्मस फ्लास्क. जो आपने सुना होगा थर्मस फ्लास्क, जिसके अंदर आप वाटर को गर्म करके स्टोर करोगे तो 3 to 4 hours के लिए एटलीस्ट, मे बी मोर, क्लियर, इफ इट इज अ बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ इंसुलेशन, तो उसके अंदर आपका जो पानी है वो गर्म रहेगा. सो वी कैनॉट से इट इज ए कम्प्लीटली आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम, बिकॉज आफ्टर सम टाइम क्लियर इट इज गोइंग टू रिलीज इट्स हीट. क्लियर? But practically we assume that under ideal conditions it can be considered as thermos plastic, can be considered as a isolated system, but ideally it is not. So we have different types of systems. First one is called open system. This is my open system. So mechanically jitne bhi aapke paas equipments hai, for example we have a compressor, we have turbine, we can say pump, all of them basically represents the, we have boiler, all of them basically are part of open system. Clear? In all these systems both mass as well as energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding, but one thing remains constant, that is called the volume. The container, the size of the volume of the boiler or pump or turbine or compressor will remain constant under all conditions. So open system basically are also known as control volume system. So jitne bhi aapke paas open system hai, they are also known as control volume system. Both are same, open system or control volume system. Secondly, as I told you, in the closed system aapke paas jo best example kya thi, that is of piston cylinder arrangement. Example is of piston cylinder arrangement with gas and all the valves closed. So this is an example of closed system in which only energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. Mass cannot be exchanged. So mass remains constant. It is basically called, just like control volume, this is called control mass system. It is called control mass. So we can call it closed system or we can call it control mass system. So mass remains constant, so it calls control mass. Volume remains constant, it is called control volume. That is for open system, that is for closed system. And last one is thermoplast. Even our universe, this is the best example of isolated system. Everything is contained in the universe. So we can say that in this system, neither mass nor energy can be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. So we have three systems: open system, which is also known as control volume system; closed system, which is also known as control mass system; and third one is called isolated system. Clear? Or system or surrounding ko जो आपके पास वॉल जो उसको सेपरेट कर रही है, दैट इज बेसिकली कॉल्ड योर बाउंड्री. सो दिस इज द बाउंड्री जो स्पेस को सेपरेट कर रही है सराउंडिंग से. वो जो वॉल है बेसिकली इट कैन बी इमेजिनरी और इट कैन बी रियल ऑल्सो. इट बेसिकली रिप्रेजेंट्स द बाउंड्री. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द सिस्टम्स. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट थर्मोडायनेमिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द थर्मल. क्लियर? Till then, please, if you guys have any query, please write me in the comment section and please subscribe my channel, that is Magnoreceptor. Thank you very much.